वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सोनिया हियर फ्रॉम ग्रोइंग क्राफ्ट। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ड्रॉपिंग इन। नाउ हियर आई एम स्टार्टिंग माय प्रोजेक्ट विद दिस ब्यूटीफुल सिलिकॉन मोल्ड एंड आई एम यूजिंग माय एयर ड्राई क्ले टू क्रिएट सम ऑफ द ब्यूटीफुल पीसेस फ्रॉम इट। नाउ टू रोल दिस अप आई एम यूजिंग माय पेंट ब्रश। आइडियली यू कैन यूज एनी ऑफ द फ्लैट सर्फेसेस, बट आई हैड माय पेंट ब्रश हैंडी सो आई जस्ट यूज्ड इट। नाउ हियर आई एम यूजिंग माय एयर ड्राई क्ले एंड दिस इज जस्ट टू मेक श्योर दैट when I use it on my glass bottle base, it works out really well. Now there are two ways of using your clay work. Either you can just demold them, let it dry for some time and then you stick it. But if you want something on a curved surface, then you can immediately use it after demolding them. Now demolding is just a process of taking out the whatever the artwork you have done in your molds, just take it out. That's called demolding, and that's how you use your embellishments. It can be resin, it can be clay, it can be POP. You can make them of any kind of material you want. So here my four pieces are ready, and now here this is an old MDF plate on which there was some old chalk paint work was done. So here I'm using my Mod Podge and I'm going to stick all my four pieces. Now honestly, after applying my Mod Podge and when I was almost on the verge of sticking my embellishments, I realized that my embellishments were a little bigger. So here, just because it is wet, I can twist and turn them as per my requirement, and that is the best part of using your air dry clay, that it gives you ample amount of time to work with it. Now here you will seeing me how I am arranging my MDF board design along with my clay work, and this looks gorgeous and beautiful. So this was definitely on my wish list since long, that I wanted to create something like this. And honestly, this panel has a very beautiful background on the side. So yes, with a little more clay work with the mold effect, it's looking absolutely gorgeous. Now here, just to do this quickly, I have used my heat gun, but I would suggest you to let it dry naturally. Now once I'm done with my sticking work, it's time to add a little more texture. So here I'm using my crafty stones and I'm adding this to my Mod Podge and I'm applying this on the sides. Now this is definitely going to add a little more strength to my base, and of course with this crafty stones I am going to add a lot of texture on the sides. Now whatever the supplies I'm using in this tutorial are mentioned in the description box with the links to buy them. That's going to really help you in your crafty shopping. So yes, here I am using my Mod Podge. Now there are other techniques where you can even use these with your gesso and your Mod Podge, and you can use your craft stones to add a little more texture. And the other thing what you can use is the granuled pieces, and those are available at Growing Craft Store. You can check the link in the description box again for that also. Now I am just applying this only on the sides of my molds. I am not doing any extra texture work on my molds designs because they are absolutely so beautiful that I really don't need to do anything else on the top of it. Now wherever I am covering it with my crafty stones, I'll make sure that I apply generous amount of my Mod Podge so that once this dries out it sticks well, otherwise it is just going to come out, and that is something which we do not want at all. Now in the crafty stones you get a lot of sizes and a lot of shapes also. I have seen that in some of the international websites. So you can just scroll down the description box and check the varieties of options which is available. Now again very quickly I am using my heat gun to dry this up. Now this is one of the most useful tool what you can have when you are doing a decoupage and your mixed media project. Now my sticking work is almost done, and it's time to start with prepping up my base. Now when I say prepping up my base, that means we need to work on the base and create a beautiful surface so that we can do our either the decoupage or the transforming work on the top of it. So here what I'm using is my DIY gesso. I have already done a detailed video on how to make your chalk paints, how to make your gesso, how to make your decoupage glue, how to make your all the mediums what is required for your mixed media and decoupage are. So you can check the tutorial. I'll mention the link in the description box for that tutorial also. Now generously applying my white gesso, and I will make sure that I apply good 2-3 coats of gesso on my base, and this is just going to make sure that my base is really pepped up for all the colors whatever we are using. Generally, when we say we are going to do mixed media art, it is assumed that we are going to use a black color gesso, and on the top of it, we are going to work out with the colors. Now, that's a myth that you need only the black gesso for your mixed media art and white gesso for your decoupage art. No. Even for your mixed media art, you can use white color gesso. Of course, the color, the way it's going to come out is going to be completely different, but yes, white gesso is also used for your mixed media art like I'm using in this product. Now I'm using an Anukul brush and I'm trying to make sure that I cover up all the areas, nicks and corners of this palette with my white color gesso, so that whenever I use the other mediums, like I am going to use a lot of colors on this one, it should blend really, really well. Now, once I apply my white gesso, I'm going to let this dry, and I'm going to even use my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and I will let this dry for a good enough of time. So yes, here we are done, and by this time we will start taking out our decoupage napkin. Now, as we are working on series of decoupage work with the Christmas theme, so I just feel that having this pretty lady on my palette is going to look really great. So here I'm using my brush water technique, and I am just going to twist turn this around, and I will just make sure that I have this pretty lady on my palette. Now I know this is of a little smaller size than the center portion, but then it's absolutely fine. Why? Because I am going to make sure that I curve the sides with the bright and nice colors really well. Now, as I have used water on my decoupage napkin, I am going to dry this up with my heat gun. Removing the layers after using your heat gun is like super easy. You really don't have to struggle with this. Now, for sticking my decoupage napkin, I will be using my Mod Podge. If you don't have a Mod Podge, you can try out with your DIY decoupage glue. The tutorial link is mentioned in the description box. You can check that. Now, applying my decoupage napkin is an like absolutely soothing experience and a soothing way of just working out with the elements, and here I am almost done with that. And yes, I will also make sure that I cover this up really well once it is dried out. And yes, please do make sure that there are no wrinkles, there are no bubbles on your decoupage napkin. Now, once my napkin has dried out, I'm going to cover this up again with a coat of Mod Podge. Now, I'm doing this as a precautionary. Why? Because now I'm going to play around a lot of material, the colors, the chalk paints, the shimmer paints. And of course, I don't want my decoupage napkin to just get merged over these things. So here, very quickly applied a coat of Mod Podge and I'm drying this up now. Now, for the color combinations, I am going to use a lot of colors, and I will make sure that I have ample of color shading work done on this one. So, but like I said, you need to make sure that your decoupage napkin and the top layers have dried out really well, otherwise it is just going to ruin your decoupage napkin. So here we are done with our decoupage work, and now it's time to start with the color blending. Now here I have picked up some of the colors. So initially I thought of doing this in white and blue theme, but then later on I just felt that I should make it a little more colorful. Let this be a different color combination, because if you see my tutorial, now I have done already a lot of color blending with blues and whites and reds, so I just thought adding a green is going to be a good tinge and shade here. Now, why I'm just swiping off my green color chalk paint a lot, because it has actually thickened. So what you need to do is just take your palette knife, keep on rubbing it like a butter, and it is just going to get smoother. Now here I'm using my fan brush to very quickly spread my colors, and here what I am also going to do is I am going to blend in the colors. Now how I'm blending the colors in this project, I'm not using any water to blending the colors. I am directly using my 2-3 shades together. Now I have picked up dark blue shade, light blue shade and a green shade, and I'm blending my colors. You can definitely choose the colors you want. You can definitely choose the color blending technique as per your convenience. Le bonheur à sculpter, de son ciseau d'enfer, souvenir.
impossible à effacer. Le bonheur est passé, à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter. Le bonheur a sculpté de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossible à effacer.
Now it's time to add a little gray to it. So here I have taken up a gray chalk paint and I'm adding some water to it, and I am just going to run this around my pretty girl, and I'll take up all the excessive gray colors with my clean tissue paper. Now this is just to make sure that it gives a nice frame effect to the girl decoupage napkin what we have used, and adding just a drop of water is going to make it smoother for me to use my gray chalk paint. Now I'm also giving a brush up look on my remaining sides just to blend in the colors really well, and just to make my work easier with this so much of carved frame, I am using my acrylic block. I have kept it beneath my frame so that it's easier for me to move it around. Now if you don't have a gray color, you can literally take a black color acrylic paint and a white acrylic paint. Just mix it to the perfect kind of color combination you are looking for the gray one, and then you can use it accordingly. And as you can see that I'm trying to blend in my pretty girl as much as I can using my gray color. You can definitely use other colors, and as per, it is going to completely depend on the kind of center artwork you have picked up. Now I'm using my heat gun to dry this up, because now this is a very important step. Once we start applying our next layer of colors, we need to make sure that the base has dried out really, really well. Okay, now here I have taken up a white color acrylic paint. Yes, you heard me right, because it is said that you don't use acrylic paints, you use only chalk paints, all the expensive paints. No, it's not that. You can use white paints also. Now just to break the monotony of the colors and merge it with my pretty girl, I'm using my white color acrylic paint a little more, adding a lot of water to it. Yes, you will see me using a lot of water here, and this is going to thin down my colors, and this is going to spread really well and merge really well with my color, and even the base colors are also going to be partially visible. Now here I have taken a very, very small round brush, and I'm covering up my frames as much as I can, and all the prominent colors what you were seeing earlier, the greens and blues, are going to settle down by this step. Now this is one of the very, very, very easy and very interesting way of doing your color blending. And now, like, I know you can witness the kind of color blending techniques what you can do with just very limited shades. The shades what I have used here are blues, green, and on the top of it I've used my gray and white. That's it, just the 4-5 shades in this one color palette, and I have just done such a beautiful color blending technique. And yes, when we say Christmas, we always think of red, white and greens, but adding a little more different shades is really going to make it a little more beautiful. So yes, here we are almost done with our color blending technique, and of course we are going to let this dry completely, and with any excessive color you can just dab it your any dry tissues and it's ready. So it's time to do our blending with the metallic paint. This is one of my favorite things to do. So take up a fan brush, just take up a tinge of metallic colors and very nicely and very gently rub it on the sides of your texture work. Now this is the time when you will actually see the effect of your texture work. Initially it's not visible, initially you might not be able to visualize that, but this is how it looks beautifully. So that's the beauty of using your metallic paints. Now I have some of the particular shades which I really love when it comes to metallic paints. So I'm sharing the link down in the description box. Do check that. Now fan brush really helps in blending the colors very well. So it is much more easier to give a very nice rustic look to your project. And you can see that how beautifully this plain like chalkboard has transformed into a beautiful metallic frame. And yes, you just need to add a hook behind it and just hang it on your entrance, or you can just make a beautiful decor piece. You can use this as a frame and this looks gorgeous. So yes, of course, when we are done with our metallic work, we are going to do the varnish work, but you need to make sure that you dry all the shades really well. Ideally, you should let it dry for good 2-3 hours and then only you move on to the varnish work so that it does not starts blending. Now at last, after 2 hours, here I'm using my varnish and I'm just trying to make sure that I apply a generous amount of varnish. Make sure you have 2-3 coats of varnish and it's done. So I really hope that you all enjoyed this tutorial. Just in case if you guys have any query, please do let me know in the comment section, and do let me know if you want me to come up with some new interesting projects, and I will surely do that. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Do subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.